Hello there. Welcome to part 3 of this tutorial. Today, I'm going to be adding a score system, player death, and fixing a silly mistake I made in the last video. Hope you enjoy. In order to make the score system, we'll need to add another node 2D, as well as a control node and a label. This will display the score while you're playing the game. Remember to resize the control node to be around the frame. Next, we'll need to add text to the label. This will be the score. Now let's add a custom font. Click on Font in Theme Override and create a new dynamic font. I'll add a custom font that fits the style of the game. It's a bit small. I'll resize it by going into the settings. I'll also need to change the color of the text. I'll use a light gray color. I'll shrink the text a bit so it's not so big. And move it to the right. Now we can see the score each time we play the game. In this game, the score is going to increase as time passes. It will also increase each time an obstacle is jumped over. But we can work on this later. First, let's add a global variable. This will allow us to access it from any script. Let's add a new script and name it global. Next, let's go into the project settings and select auto load. Name the path global and connect it to the global.gd script. Let's open up the script and add a score variable. This variable can now be accessed in any of the other scripts we add. I'll rename the label score and connect it to a script as well. Create a physics function. Add the score variable inside the string. Remember to add global before the variable's name. In order to make the score increase each second, we'll need to add a timer. I'll rename this score timer. Connect it to the score label. Now let's add a timeout signal to the script. Make sure to select the score script. This will automatically add a function to the script. With this simple line of code, the game will add a point each second. Also, select auto start so the game automatically starts the timer. Great! It's working! The next thing I want to do is add a point each time the player jumps over an obstacle. In the player node, select node, then group. This will add a group to the player. I'll name this player. Next, we can add an area 2D node to the obstacle, as well as a collision shape. I'll rename it detection and add another shape. Let's extend the collision shape upwards so that it will detect when the player hits it. That's high enough. Now let's add a script to the obstacle. We'll need to add a body entered signal to the obstacle from the area 2D. This will detect the player group. Now we can code the detection. What this code will do is add a point each time the player group intersects with the area 2D. Nice. As you can see, 5 points got added. Finally, we can add the player death. Before I do this, however, I've got some explaining to do. In my last video, I said this. The obstacles will be similar to the player. First, I'll add a kinematic body. This will actually create a bunch of problems that I don't want to deal with. Oopsies, let me just fix this real quick. There, all better. Let's add another body entered signal. In this function, we'll make another function that allows the player to detect collision with another object. Basically, this will allow the player to be hit by the obstacles. Player hit will be our custom function name. We'll add this to the player later. For now, we can add the health variable. I'll set the health to be 1 so the player dies instantly. Next, let's add our function. The health will go down by 1 each time the player is hit. If our player's health is equal to 0, the player will lose. It works. Yippee. Thanks for watching this video. If you made it this far, why not subscribe? Please. Have a good day, see you later.